Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Pikaia has been a key topic of interest for the creatures discovered from the Cambrian era, Burgess Shale, British Columbia, Canada, mainly because it was once believed to have been closely related to the ancestor of all vertebrates. 16 specimens were known from the Greater Phyllopod bed, which includes tens of thousands of soft-bodied fossils representing over 150 genera, and the Pikaia fossils made up 0.03% of the community. Nonetheless, there is still controversy as to what it actually was. Thus, its exact phylogenetic position is uncertain. Proposed affinities include a stem chordate, not closely related to any extant lineage, craniata, or cephalochordata. Pikaia was a primitive chordate that didn't have a well-defined head and was around 1.5 inches in length, or 38 millimeters. It had a pair of rather large antenna-like tentacles on its head and a series of short appendages, which may be linked to gill slits on either side of its head. These traits make it different from modern-day lancelets. The tentacles on its head may be similar to those of the present-day hagfish, a jawless chordate. Although rather primitive, Pikaia's traits fit the prerequisites for vertebrates. It was a compressed, leaf-shaped animal with an expanded tail fin, with its flattened body divided into pairs of segmented muscle blocks, which can be observed as faint vertical lines. Its muscles were on either side of a pliable appendage resembling a rod that runs from the tip of the head to the tip of the tail. In 1979, Simon Conway Morris noted the presence of a proto-notochord, which is an anatomical structure that creatures would later on develop into a spine, leading to the creation of the first true chordates. In a nutshell, chordates are vertebrates, animals sharing a trait, a hard backbone. This group also includes humans. The quality of preservation of the 535 million year old Burgess shale is so good that fossils of Pikaia even show small traces of soft tissues. We can observe the axial notochord and V-shaped muscle blocks, typical of the pre-vertebrate cephalochordates. Its notochord is rather stiff, yet pliable, and can be bent into sinuous waves for swimming by pulses of contractions from the muscle blocks on either side of it. Although merged with the body, Pikaia is noted for still having a distinct head. Its anatomy closely resembles the contemporary creature, Brachiostoma, a lancelet. With paired muscle blocks and a notochord, the lancelet and Pikaia belong to the chordate group of animals from which the vertebrates descended. And to give a little background as to lancelet's current position, molecular studies have refuted earlier hypotheses that lancelets might be the closest living relative to the vertebrates, instead favoring tunicates in this position. Other fossil and extant groups like graptolites and acorn worms, which are even more primitive. Currently, it is the oldest known chordate in the fossil record, meaning that it or another similar creature is their ancestor, except that was the outdated description. Allow me to explain. Morris went so far as to suggest that Pikaia was itself a vertebrate animal, or chordate, which consequently led to the speculation that Pikaia may have been the ancestor to all vertebrates, including humans. This is a key element of controversy behind Pikaia, mainly due to the fact that not everyone is convinced that it was actually a chordate. It has been suggested to have had a segmented exoskeleton, as well as short tentacles, which are both anatomical features of invertebrates, which are creatures without a backbone. Thus, it can be assigned conclusively. Additionally, when Pikaia was first described by Charles Walcott in 1911, it was described as a type of polychaete worm due to the regular segmentation of the body. Nowadays, the paleontological community's research has shed light as to what it actually was, with most envisioning it as a cephalochordate, similar to the lancelet that we know nowadays. Pikaia may have been related to the true ancestors of the chordates, yet it was still separate from them. The presence of a creature as physiologically complex as Pikaia, some 530 million years ago during the Middle Cambrian, provides support for the controversial view that the diversification of life must have extended back well before Cambrian times, perhaps deep into the Precambrian. And in support of this view is the discovery of Metasprigina, a primitive fish of similar age which appears to have already begun to develop a jaw and the presence of conodonts. The teeth of an extinct type of fish belonging to the agnatha before Pikaia, thus provide support for that view. The first sign of head development or cephalization can be observed in chordates like the branchiostoma and Pikaia. It is believed that the development of a head structure was a result of a mouth at the end that came into contact with the environment first, as the animal swam forward, a long body shape and a swimming habit. The search for food was an evolutionary pressure that required ways of continually testing what lay ahead. Thus, it is thought that anatomical structures for feeling, smelling, and seeing developed around the mouth. The data these structures gathered was processed by swelling of the nerve cord, which is also known as efflorescence, the precursor of the brain. Altogether, these front-end structures form the distinct part of the vertebrate body called the head. The exact lifestyle of Pikaia is uncertain, but from phylogeny we can deduce that it was similar to lancelets, probably a free-swimming creature that moved through the water with side-to-side undulations of its body like an eel. It may have been rather slow, mainly due to the fact that it lacked the fast twitch fibers that are essential for rapid swimming in modern chordates. As it swam through the water, it may have picked up small chunks of organic matter that were filtered and then digested in the gut. Pikaia was named after Pika Peak, a mountain in Alberta, Canada. It was named by Charles Walcott in 1911. Species include the type, which is Pikaia grasslands. Its diet is uncertain, but could have possibly been tiny lumps of organic matter. It was rather small, at 1.5 inches or 38 millimeters long. It has been found in the Burgess Shale of British Columbia, Canada. It lived during the Middle Cambrian 530 million years ago. And fossil representation includes many individuals. And with that, thank you for watching this Prehistoric Beast program episode of a series of jawless fishes. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.